The Duffalo Bar from Kabuki Strength is by far one of the most popular specialty bars ever created. However, for a lot of people, it's too expensive, and I understand it. It's a pretty basic bar. There's not a whole lot of variation between it. There's not a whole lot of variation from it from a standard Olympic bar. So I can understand why people are balking at the price. Up until this point, there really hasn't been a good budget Duffalo bar. There's been some that are like from New York Barbells that are kind of a cheaper bar, but they haven't been that good. That's changed with this bar. This is the FringeSport Longhorn Bar. It's pretty much an exact clone of the Duffalo Bar. There's very small differentiation between them. However, there is a big price difference. This bar is about $400 shipped to your door versus the Kabuki Strength Duffalo Bar that's a couple hundred more and then you tack on more for shipping. Today we're gonna review this bad boy and tell you what the differences are between it and the Duffalo Bar and whether we recommend it or not. Let's do it. The Duffalo Bar from Kabuki Strength is without question one of our favorite specialty bars. We recommend it often and use it even more. However, for many, the price is far out of their budget. Enter the FringeSport Longhorn Buffalo Bar. Featuring a similar arch, knurling placement, and shaft diameter during use, you'll have a hard time telling the difference between the two. The FringeSport Longhorn Buffalo Bar is an excellent specialty bar. It's made in the USA, something that FringeSport seems to be employing more of in their products, and features many of the things sought after in a higher-end specialty bar. The knurling is surprisingly good. Thankfully, companies are focusing on this more, and the arch is comparable to the top dog in the category, the Kabuki Strength Duffalo Bar. Now, I plan to discuss the Duffalo Bar probably quite a few times throughout this review because it's the one being compared to. The FringeSport Longhorn Buffalo Bar is a direct challenger to the Duffalo Bar at a lower price and with a few minor changes for cost reasons. Starting with the shaft, FringeSport has gone with 165,000 PSI tensile strength steel. In comparison to the steel that many bars utilize today, that's rather low. Even some bars under $200. The Wonder Bar from FringeSport is a perfect example of this. But those bars have a tensile strength of over 200,000 PSI. However, and this is an important distinction, most Olympic bars go from 28 to 29 millimeters. The Longhorn Buffalo Bar is 32 millimeters, making it similar to squat bars that are used by the world's strongest powerlifters during max back squats. The 32 millimeter diameter of the Longhorn Bar has a few advantages. One, it increases the stiffness of the bar. Two, due to the thickness of the shaft, it requires a lot less tensile strength of the steel used to create a bar that won't deform during normal use. And three, a thicker bar simply feels better on the back during squats. If you've never tried squatting with a bar other than something around 28 to 29 millimeters, you'll be in for quite a treat when you put something like this Longhorn Bar on your back. 32 millimeters, although only a few millimeters thicker than a standard Olympic bar, makes a world of a difference in terms of feel. Combine that with the arch of the bar, and there isn't a better feeling bar to squat with other than maybe the Duffalo Bar. The arch of the bar appears to be pretty much the exact same as the Kabuki Strength Duffalo Bar, which is a good thing. One of the biggest changes from the older style Buffalo bars that's been around for decades is an increased arch that feels better on the back and changes where the weight is in relation to your back due to a lower camber. I'd love to see the machine that's used to bend a piece of steel in this manner, especially one that's 32 millimeters thick and does it in a way that's consistent. You know, if you want to see something that's not consistent, check out the Titan Bison Bar for something that's kind of unsafe. We get asked on that all the time and no, we don't recommend it. But a 32 millimeter shaft cannot be easy to bend, especially so that it appears steady. In addition to the bend of the bar, we were impressed by the knurling. Too often companies will overlook the knurling on specialty bars, but for bars like trap bars, like we see with the new Kabuki Strength trap bar, Buffalo bars, and others that feature knurling, it matters as much as Olympic bars. The knurling on the Longhorn Buffalo Bar is aggressive, but not sharp in a way you'd find on, say, a deadlift bar. In fact, it feels and appears to be very similar to our most recommended power bar, the Rogue Ohio Power Bar, which has a volcano-type knurl, meaning the peaks of the knurl are chopped off to provide more surface area of the knurl to grip your hand if you're benching with it or your shirt, because you can do both with a Buffalo Bar. The spacing of the knurl and knurl marks, including a center knurl mark, are similar to the Duffalo Bar, yet another reason we feel the goal of the bar was to be a clone. It's very similar. The part of the bar that is not a clone are the sleeves. The Duffalo Bar includes extra long sleeves for those that like the inventor of the bar, squat 900 plus pounds. Since a specialty bar isn't required to meet the specs required by meat organizations like the IPF, I think it's a great idea. However, it does add to the steel it's used, and likely therefore the cost to the consumer, and will largely be unused by a majority of the population. With this in consideration, FringeSport decided to go with a standard sleeve length and design of 16.5 inches. The Duffalo bar is actually 17.25 inches of loadable area, which is quite a bit larger. In addition to the length, the Duffalo bar has an accessory attachment point where a hook can be screwed in for bands. We haven't used it, and sits on bronze bushings while the Longhorn Buffalo bar sits on inferior roll pins. Not that really that's an incredibly important, as it's not going to be used for Olympic lifts, but it is a pretty expensive bar, so being expensive, it's nice to have nice features, and bushings would be nice to see on it. To be honest, for the price, there isn't much we dislike about the Longhorn Buffalo bar. We typically have a long list of things, but really not a ton for this bar because they just took what Duffalo bar did and made it cheaper and actually made it better in some ways. Despite being cheaper than the Duffalo bar, it's still pricey at $400. The only thing we'd like to see are the roll pins replaced with bronze bushings, but that's being pretty nitpicky, like I said, and definitely not necessary for a bar of this sort. Overall, we were extremely impressed by the Longhorn Buffalo bar. It's not as good as the Duffalo bar overall, but it's also much cheaper and an overall better value for most. If you're looking for a high quality Buffalo bar with similar specs as the best, aka the Duffalo bar, but a lower price, nearly $300 with shipping, then we highly recommend the Longhorn Buffalo bar from FringeSport. Just understand that this is a copy of the Duffalo bar. It's very similar. So if you want to help out the inventor and you want to support them in that manner, then you should probably go with the Duffalo bar. But if you're like, you know, the Buffalo bar has been around for a long time, it's not a big deal that it was copied, then go with the FringeSport. We'll put a link in the bio below that you can check out the bar. This has been Coop from GarageGymReviews.com. Let me know what you think of the bar. Are you willing to go with a more value-based bar? Are you willing to go with the budget version? Or would you rather just spend the extra money and go all out for the best one? Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Peace. We'll be right back.